Welcome once again to Primetime Wrestling. I'm Gorilla Monsoon along with
Bobby the
Incognito.
Incognito.
The laughter from Studio B knows what I'm talking about. Well, the reason I'm dressed in black, because I'm in mourning for the Heenan family, that's probably why you're wearing black as well.
I just decided to...
Tommy...
You just got in off the golf course.
Yeah.
Tell me something... I'm a survivor. The glasses, it wouldn't be to hide them big black eyes, would it?
I don't see why
Turkey Day wasn't too good for you, was it?
I don't like holidays. I never have liked holidays. Talk about Andre and Haku. You want to talk about a good tag team?
I'd much prefer to talk about the Brainbusters.
Well, there's nothing to talk about. The Brainbusters are history as far as I'm concerned.
Well, you could be
history. They're finished.
Too,
they're done as far as I'm concerned. Drop the subject right there.
Big
feature matchup here this week on Primetime Wrestling, right here on the USA Network. The big powerhouse, Hercules, taking on the African Dream, Akeem. What a classic confrontation that's going to be. And a special brother love with Hot Rod. You won't want to miss that for love or money. Rod, you're laughing. I know you're laughing.
But he's the same guy that sucker punched him with a lead pumpkin a couple months ago.
You're going to have a good time with this one. You're going to have a great time with this one. I know I did. I don't know. Maybe you won't. I know I'm having a much better time than Boobs is.
We're all having a great time.
Yeah, you wish you were having a great time.
Do I look like I'm having a good time?
No, it doesn't look like you're having a good time.
I'd be having a better time if you were gone and Studio B was closed.
I'm sure you would. Here's a guy that's having a great time in the World Wrestling Federation, Jake the Snake. Jake the Snake, obviously back 100% here in the World Wrestling Federation. You know, I didn't notice any kind of a limp or anything, and that leg is healed 100%, and this guy's going to create a lot of problems for a lot of people.
Oh, he always has. He's a very dangerous man. But I don't think he's right up here. I think he's still worried about DiBiase. Because every time a guy puts you on the shelf or does some damage to you, you're constantly worried about that man. Just like Piper's worried about Rude. I know that.
Hot Rod, let's face it. DiBiase didn't get the job done, did he?
No, didn't even come close to getting the job done. And the same thing when it comes to Rude. You know, now I'm facing a situation where you got lumberjacks. You got lumberjacks all over the place. And I got a situation where I have Rude and I have to contend with a bunch of animals that just want to eat both of us. This is becoming a very ugly war. But you know what? No retreat. No surrender, because I am a survivor.
Huh? You belong in a cage.
Talk about big holiday festivities. Talk about the holiday season, the Christmas time. A special package put together for you by the World Wrestling Federation. It'll happen Wednesday, December 27th. And here's a colleague of ours, longtime personal friend of mine, Mean Gene Okerlund, to tell you all about it.
The only friend he's got.
And just in time for you to mark down that date, Wednesday, December 27th, on your new 1990 WWF calendar. This is what it's all about. It's the holiday season. What a gift this makes.
They swerved me on that calendar.
What do you mean they swerved you?
When they put everybody's picture.
You were swerved when you were born. What is it?
And when they put everybody's picture in that calendar, they didn't approach me in time. My picture's not in the calendar.
My heart bleeds.
They'll never sell.
Oh, too bad, huh? Coming up in mere moments right here on Primetime Wrestling, the Macho King, Randy Savage. Most interesting matchup. He's in there with a youngster, a guy who's really made a name for himself here in the World Wrestling Federation, referring to Paul Roma.
Paul Roma's got a lot of potential. I see a lot in this guy.
Uh-oh.
What?
He'll never become a member of the Heenan family. Never.
Oh, probably not.
Never in a million years.
He's got
years.
A long way to go to become a member of my family.
And you want to see somebody that's really outrageous, keep your eye on the Queen, Sherry. Here it is right now, the Macho King and his queen.
What a queen.
Can you believe a referee of the World Wrestling Federation allowing the queen to get away with some of that stuff? I don't think that's right.
I was reading something. I missed
it. Yeah, I'm sure. Yeah, yeah. You don't care about what's going on here, right? Well, your job is in jeopardy here.
Well, my job.
I figure if anybody knows anything about queens, it would be Bobsy. And what bothers me, though, is I'm starting where I can't tell the difference between Savage and Scary Sherry. So Scary Sherry's biceps are getting bigger. Savage hair is getting longer. I can't tell the difference anymore. Starting to scare me. But I know who could tell the difference. Boobs. Couldn't you, Boobs?
You know, he's got a lot of room to talk about how somebody dresses. Guy's got a $4 t-shirt on and one of Shirley Temple's old skirts, and he's going to make fun of Sherry?
Are we still hiding?
Pardon?
Are we still hiding?
No, I'm not hiding.
Take.
It's me.
Just leave him off.
Where'd you leave your purse?
No, put him back
on. I don't have a purse.
It's hard to tell anymore without a scorecard. Who's carrying a purse? Who's not carrying a
Sherry
purse?
Sherry has a purse.
Coming up in mere moments.
I don't have a purse.
We're going to take a look.
I have a wallet.
A debut at Al
Money
Perez. Card.
Ooh.
Oh, boy, I can hardly wait to see this week. Now, last time I saw Rick the Model Martel, he was the flamingo dancer spanking his heels, taking his clothes, going, ooh, telling everybody how pretty he was. This week, from Lord Alfred Hayes, who's a friend of mine and I like very much, but, Lord, I'm starting to be bothered with you. Here, I want you to introduce the model, and let's just check out the attire of the beautiful model this particular day.
Now, ladies and gentlemen.
I like that. Alfred, how well he coordinated his colors. He's all, excuse me, you shaving your legs? Is that a Remington you're using there? Have you ever, I see with that tennis racket, the thing around the, oh, yeah. Croquet? Go play croquet? What is this? Rick the Model, you have lost it. You know, of course, the only other person I'd rather see it, I'd like to see two people in that outfit. Rude would look good in that outfit. Boobsy would look good in that outfit. I would see them.
You know, it's obvious. You know nothing about the proper attire to wear in country clubs.
I suppose
you've never been to a country club.
No.
Anytime you've been to a yard where there's activities, it had barbed wire fence and guards.
That, you know, for the first time, you told the truth. I suppose you were part of his fashion coordinator, were you?
Myself and two other gentlemen did give our opinions.
You helped design that little ensemble for him, did you? Huh? You know, he reminds me of Miss Piggy when he does that.
You know what gets me? There obviously is no conceit in the Martel family.
Why
he has it all.
Oh.
Here's Al Perez. How can you be sure? How can you be sure that was Conquistador number one? Why couldn't it be Conquistador number two?
Because Conquistador number one wears a mask.
Why, you dummy, they both were. Hot Rod, what'd you think of that helicopter move of Al Perez?
I tell you, it's something that I wouldn't want done to me. It's a very impressive move. I think the best part is it does. A lot of people, it's just a revision of the airplane spin, but a lot of people from the airplane spin will just go into a pinning combination. I like the way he heave-holds at the end of it and a way that Conquistador goes tumbling. One thing I don't like doing, I don't like wrestling a masked man because it's hard to see what he's going to do. It's hard. He can feign a lot, but Al Perez, I thought, did excellent.
Well, the guy was upside down, you know, that's...
But I heard a lot of girls like to go with Roddy if he wears a mask. Let me tell you something about Al Perez. That's a very great finishing maneuver with a 250-pound, 275-pound guy. Try that on Andre the Giant, pal.
You got
that's
the
like
right
trying to,
momentum
that's like
going,
trying
you
to jumpstart a 747.
Oh, will you stop.
I'm going to try that.
You want some good news?
Yeah.
We'll be right back with bad news.
Good news.
Bad News Brown has one of the most impressive win records of anyone here in the World Wrestling Federation, and somehow or other, he seems to have been looked over by the championship committee. Why is that, Brain?
Well, the reason I can come up with is...
This will be good.
Hulk Hogan's probably paying off Jack Tunney to keep Bad News away from him.
Uh-huh.
See, Hulk Hogan's fine when he's in there against another wrestler, but when you're in there a man who does street fighting and just as bad as he is, Hogan doesn't know what
to
do.
That's what I thought. You don't have a clue.
I have a clue.
Let's go to the match. He did it again.
Very impressive.
Bad news. Put another one in the win column.
Told you. Call Hogan.
How
see if he's ready.
Hot Rod, how would you go in there if you were signed a contract and the other guy's name on it was bad news? What kind of strategy would you use?
Would bad news love to get a hold of a guy in a
did
skirt?
Did I ask you a question? No, I asked Hot Rod.
Sorry.
Not accepted. Sorry. Besides that, you're clumsy. I wouldn't have you for a manager. First thing I'd do is I'd get rid of the manager. Second thing I'd do, with a guy like Bad News, I would take it right to him as hard as I could because he's the kind of guy, you don't wear him out, you're going to have to fight him toe-to-toe, so you might as well just go for it. I would try to stick to the legs, though. I would try to go and I'd try to go down low in the basement and leg dive him and get him down on the mat because I think he's most dangerous when he's standing up. He's a very good judo player and a good wrestler, but a better judo player, and judo players are better. best on their feet. So completely, I would go for the legs and try to take them down to the mat.
Rod, he completely ignores the referee, completely ignores the rules of the World Wrestling Federation, has lost a couple of matches along the way, I understand, due to disqualifications for just that reason.
Dangerous guy, a very
Here's
dangerous
guy. Here's a
guy
that's never been disqualified in his entire life, and I doubt will ever be, Sean Mooney.
Who cares?
Well, I don't know if President Bush he is. I don't think so. I don't know that horseshoes has anything to do. Who cares? However, he's got the genius with him. Now who really cares? He does. Says he's perfect. Says he's a perfect pitcher. Perfect catcher, too. I've seen him catch a few. But who am I to judge before? Let's open the door and take a look at Mr. Perfect.
Well, he made five ringers.
Five ringers? He only made four.
Did you see that guy standing in the back there with a cloak on? That's a ringer if I ever saw one.
You know, Andre the Giant holds a record for horseshoes.
Is that right? Eating them?
No, through four horseshoes at the same time, one ringer. Of course, the horse was still in him. That's the difference.
The shoes for braces after eating villagers.
Hot Rod, Mr. Perfect has done a lot of things that we've seen over the months, and none of them have anything to do with wrestling.
Well, you know what the guy is trying to do is he's trying to make a rep for himself, and he's trying to psych some people out by showing that he's a good athlete in basketball and that he can dive off a diving board. I mean, things we all did as a kid.
I don't believe this. What? You said he's done all these things the last couple months, but nothing to do with wrestling? He's undefeated in the World Wrestling Federation. Hogan can't say that. Hogan was defeated by Andre the Giant. Hogan's been disqualified. He's been beaten. Perfect is perfect.
So what you're telling me that Perfect could beat Hogan, is that what you're
yes,
saying?
Yes, I think it's time.
When Hogan cashes in at the end of the day and puts that WWF Championship belt in its little box, only he can do that, not Mr. Perfect.
Mr. Perfect will do it eventually.
Let's take a look at Tito Santana against that big Russian blowhard, Mr. Borazukov.
See the size of the cranium on that boy. You know, if he had any sense at all, he'd be using that head against Tito Santana. Tito Santana ain't the kind of guy that you can take a lax attitude toward. Of course, you finding that out, Borazukov. We're going to see after this, too. Oh, although Boris is doing very well, sometimes you can catch him in the locker room going, I'm a human. But at this particular point, he's got himself where he's trying to make a reputation at Tito Santana's expense. Mistake-o.
Tito Santana still putting it all together. What a tough guy, huh?
I have a riddle for you.
Oh.
Why is Tito Santana like a cue ball?
Like a cue ball.
Don't know.
The harder you strike them, the more English you get out of them.
That's not very nice.
How much English are you going to get out of Andre and Haku?
Speaking of Andre and Haku, this Saturday, I will be in Lakeland, Florida at the Lakeland Civic Arena.
Speaking of Lakeland, you know, I'm just going to happen to be there myself. Oh, Boobs, would you like a ride down?
No, thank you. And Sunday, I'm at the Miami Arena, Miami, Florida.
You know something?
You're Sunday, there, too.
I just happened to be passing through Miami. Would you like a ride down?
And Monday, everybody's going to go to the beach and see where Rude buried Piper.
you're a sick person. You know?
Thank you.
You're a very sick person. I ain't even close to finish with Rude. I'm going to finish the entire Heenan family off. You wanted war, baby. War you got.
Hey,
I can't
Piper?
Stand talking to him.
Shut up.
Coming up when we come back in mere moments, we've got an interesting match with the Brawler and then Brother Love with Hot Rod. Or Hot Rod with Brother Love.
I don't think you should show that.
Brooklyn Brawler. Boy, it's been all downhill for him since he left under the wing in the tutelage of Pat Patterson and terrible Terry Garvin.
Oh, he's from this Terry Garvin School of Self-Defense.
That's right.
Very capable.
I don't think he finished the course myself.
Well, you know, if I need a job done, I still contact a brawler and have him do a little work for me on the side. He's a very dangerous man.
Yeah, especially if you get close to him. He stinks. Well, Never takes a bath.
He likes to be in his element. He likes the smell of the alleys.
Let's see if he can solve the moves of Jose Luis Rivera.
Won't be hard.
In the garden. Brooklyn Brawler back on the win streak here. Oh, one in a row, huh?
He's doing quite well.
Folks, don't you dare leave your seat. Don't touch your dial, because coming up in mere moments here, there's something you definitely will not want to miss.
Wait a minute. You're the first one. Every time Brother Love comes on, you tell everybody to go out and make a sandwich, go change the oil on their car, go mail their Christmas packages in June. Now's the time for you people to leave the house.
No,
you don't
want
to see this. I suggest
now's the time for you to see Brother Love.
No, go do something
that he really deserves to be in. Take it. Did you not enjoy that?
That is a disgrace. That is the most humiliating thing you can do to a person. First of all, Piper is 10 times tougher than that man. Takes advantage of that man who means harm to no one.
No.
Bad enough a month ago, he sucker punched him with a...
Oh, he
knocked him out with a punk, and a month ago, made a fool out of him.
Uh-huh.
Sure, we were on Brother Love's show.
You and he didn't conspire to set up the hot rod, did you? No.
Didn't Piper have him down putting toothpaste in his mouth, humiliating the man?
Payback
now
is
do
hell.
This.
Nobody said payback was fun. Payback
okay,
is hell.
Fine, then we know the rules too, Piper.
Wouldn't you look good in a diaper?
It's about time.
I'd love to see that.
You learned the rules. It's about time you understood that this ain't no playground. That I'm fighting for real. That I ain't playing with you or nobody else. I'm fighting a war, and I ain't stopping till it's finished.
Good.
It's about time you realized it.
Good. You fight that war, pal. And you do whatever you can to fight it. But the bottom line is I got more friends than you do. And I'm smarter than you are. And you're going to make mistakes along the way. And when you make mistakes, pal, we're going to capitalize on it. And you and that cheap little miniskirt is going to be shoved down your throat so far, you're going to wish you never heard the word Brother Love, Bobby Heenan, or anything else, punk.
You're wrong on both counts.
You're a pig, and that's all there is to it.
You don't have more friends, and you're not smarter.
Why don't you do something about it?
Bring Rude. Bring Rude and do something. Bring the whole
damn clan. You want me to bring Rude here? I'll bring Rude here.
Bring him then.
No, you won't.
Well, what's he trying to do? He's trying to coax me into something.
Rod, just cool it.
He's getting scared, huh?
I'm not getting scared. I'm scared of you.
Don't get bent out of shape. You want to see some whacking? Stay with us. The Bushwhackers are coming. Bushwhackers, I always enjoy watching them, and they're coming up right now on Primetime Wrestling, and I'm sure that over the past week or 10 days, they've picked up a lot of pointers from you, Hot Rod. True or false? Where is Hot Rod? Studio B is empty.
Uh-oh. Something's going on here now. Sucker me into nothing.
Just because the guy's not there? Give me a break.
No, that chair's tipped over. He left quick. He's up to something.
Maybe he had
he didn't go to a phone call.
Room.
He didn't go to the big boys, little boys room, or no boys room. He's up to something. He's loose in this facility right now.
You're loose.
Now,
you're loose. Up. You're paranoid.
You told me nothing would happen. You made me promise. I've never gone over there. He's on his way. He's up to something. Now,
why
something's going to happen here. I'm concerned. I'm worried.
Relax. As long as you sit there and I'm sitting here, there's nothing going to happen.
No. Something's going on. Director!
Boy, is he sick.
Poor man. Somebody find out where he is right now.
You talk about the Bushwhackers needing help.
I'm leaving. I can't leave. Wait a minute. I got no place to go.
That's right.
Well, somebody...
Let's take a look at the Bushwhackers. We'll enjoy this.
You promised me. You better find out right now.
Will you relax? What is wrong with you?
Plenty wrong with me.
Didn't you enjoy the Bushwhackers? Are they something?
I didn't even watch it.
No, you didn't. You kept looking over your shoulder.
I'm watching the door.
Let's tune in to Studio B and see who, if any... Yeah, there he is. There he is right there. What's wrong with that? Can you see him? Hot Rod? Hot Rod, where'd you go? This guy's paranoid.
Oh, just went and stretched my legs a little bit. That's all.
What's wrong
with that? Guy gets cramped up. You know, Gorilla, it's funny. Guy doesn't realize these studios really aren't that far apart. You ever notice that? You know, if a fella could just... get past all that stuff and to that door, he could say hello, couldn't he?
Absolutely, but it's not allowed. You know that, Hot Rod. That's part of our agreement that you stay in your studio and...
I wouldn't
And you just stay here, buddy.
Staying right here.
You won't be
You
in
told
any
me
trouble.
Nothing happened to me, and you're going to be responsible for it.
Here's a guy that's causing all kinds of trouble here in the WWF, Sean Mooney. What makes you think I'm happy with you behind me here? I don't like anybody to get behind me.
You're responsible. You said you had nothing to worry about.
If you sat right over there where you belong, I'd still be responsible. Boy, oh boy, what I have to put up with here.
What's wrong, Bobby? You got nothing to worry about. Why, I don't mean you any harm.
See that?
Yes, he does.
I mean, I wouldn't lay a finger on you.
I have a history of neck injuries. Everybody knows that.
He's out to hurt me. He's out to do something. I know it. I know it, Monsoon.
Well,
why don't you leave?
Why don't you just get up and go?
Sure, and have him sucking me out there in the hall and something happened to me? Me and Jimmy Hoffa would be sleeping in an end zone?
Wouldn't be the first time you were suckered, would it? Interesting matchup coming up as our feature this week on Primetime Wrestling. The big guy, Hercules, taking on the African Dream,
Akeem.
What a matchup taking place. Hercules surprising everyone except perhaps me with that awesome power display of his. The African Dream is in trouble.
Tell him.
I don't like anybody behind me. We'll be back in just a moment with the exciting conclusion of this matchup. I'm not happy about this arrangement at all. I have to keep checking my poke all the time.
I wouldn't roll you. I wouldn't pick your pocket.
No.
Not that kind of a guy.
Not unless you got a chance, right? How about the change?
I wouldn't go through your pockets.
Please. Let's go back to ringside. Well, the creep is finally gone. Oh, no, there he is.
What?
Why don't you get back over on your own side?
Because I don't want to be over there. It's too close to the door. You go over there.
You think there isn't a door over there?
I didn't know there was a door there.
There's a door behind here as well.
Behind here?
You're not safe anywhere here unless...
Let me get in that chair.
Fat chance you got to get in this chair.
Well, you can sit in this chair then.
Will you stop?
I feel like I'm in a cab.
Rod, can you do something about this?
See? You're threatening me.
I wouldn't threaten you, but I want you to know something.
Him?
That sometimes a guy like me can only take so much and only have so much fun in life until it all turns around where he just don't care anymore about anything. He just wants to eliminate the thorn that's jabbing in his side, and he don't care how he does it. Of course, I'm not that kind of guy right now.
See?
I'm mild-mannered, hopeful.
There's a thorn in my side right now, literally.
You tell him.
Not figuratively, but literally.
Tell him.
I am telling him.
He's stern about it.
Why don't you get over there where you belong?
Right,
before I knock you out!
I'm asking for a little help.
You're a little help. You need a lot of help. You're going to get a bill, too. You've been sneezing and coughing and spitting all over the back of my suit.
It's the air conditioning unit.
It is, huh?
It's dripping.
Folks, don't forget, mark that date down on your calendar. Wednesday, December 27th, our big Christmas special. We'll have more information in the weeks to come about it on the movie and the match, No Holds Barred, or the match and the movie, however you want to put it together.
Is it on pay-per-view?
Don't you know anything?
Just ask him.
No.
You're so paranoid about Studio B. Hot Rod, do me a favor. Would you assure this guy that you're not headed in this direction?
This is the end of the show, boobs, and I'm calm and mild mannered. I just want you to do one thing, though.
I want you
to tell Ravishing Rick Rude what you saw with Brother Love. And I want you tonight, I want you to lay down, and I want you to think about what you saw. And I want you both to think about what you did. And I want you to think about the time that you were laughing when you put the mouthwash in my face, Rude. And all the fun you were having. And I want you to think, was it worth it now? I'm coming. And I'm coming strong. And I ain't backing off for no one now. We'll see you later.
You don't scare me, Piper.
Awesome.
I got plans for this weekend. Like I said, I'm going to be in Lakeland, Florida. I'm going to be in Miami. And I'm not going to have you spoil any fun for me.
So
and if I got to go over there myself, kick open that door, I'm not going to do it. Because I'm smarter than that. And I'm bigger than you are mentally.
Yes,
tell him.
Boy, are you sick. Until next week, so long, everyone.
See ya.
Tell him.
Get out.